participants in this study then came into our laboratory in a fasted state, and we measured their resting metabolic rate first, and we did that for everybody, and that meant that we had a good idea of the amount of energy it requires for them just to lay still and sustain themselves just being there. Then we had them in a random order lay down, sit down, or stand up. So some people did the reverse order, some people sat down first, and actually we just put a television documentary on, a kind of non-emotive documentary, so that wouldn't affect their kind of level of metabolism. We then took air samples using indirect calorimetry from expired gases, which essentially just means that an individual breathing through a tube and we can collect their expired gases will allow us to then determine how many grams of carbohydrate and fat that they're metabolizing, and therefore determine how many calories they're expending or the energy cost of the activity. The primary finding of this experiment, and the one we're most interested in, was actually the sitting versus standing comparison. And we observed that standing expended 12% more energy than sitting. What that equates to, in the kind of numbers that people might be familiar with, is about 9 calories per hour. That small amount really isn't going to do very much in relation to energy balance if you thought that standing at your desk was going to help you lose weight. And although we didn't measure it in this study, there's a lot of other literature now looking at the health benefits of standing. And in fact, even those studies are starting to suggest that actually what we need to be focusing on is getting to people to really do more. And leaving your chair is really just the first step in that process.